Today, I'm going to school Todd about one great reason to move to McKinney.
Stay tuned so you can find out how wrong he is. What's up, folks? Todd Tremonti here with my buddy Mason Goss, usually behind the camera, running the mics. But today, we've given him, as a trial situation,
they let me loose,
opportunity to get in front of the camera and on the microphone to help us talk a little bit about McKinney, Texas. So many of our videos are about moving to the area or about what's great about the area. And we've got a little series going here. You've probably caught on to some of the top reasons to move to some of the areas within the DFW Metroplex. And one of the best reasons to move to McKinney, Texas is downtown McKinney. Really, really cool area on the east side of McKinney, just off 75 or Central Expressway. And really has, there's a lot of kind of older downtown areas within the Metroplex that have really made a great effort, but haven't all the way delivered on a really cool experience. And McKinney has. Downtown McKinney really has, for a long time, been a really neat area for restaurants, entertainment, shopping, a weekend away. My wife and I have been down there for a couple of just kind of night out for our anniversary type deal. We love the Grand Hotel down there for a nice dinner. Rick's is a restaurant there in the hotel. There's a couple of retail wineries down there. There's some ice cream and pie and all that stuff. We'll tell you some of our favorites in a minute. But it's kind of a quadrant right around kind of the town square there in downtown McKinney. And then off of the town square, you still have some retail, but you also have some older historic homes, some really, really cool places as far as residential living places to literally buy a home or rent and live there.
Yeah, they have some really cool apartments. Yeah. I have a friend that lived right by. You just walked to all the downtown area and they're... It was real close.
Yeah, so they've done a good job with kind of the urban lifestyle opportunity there without it being anything like an urban Dallas or Fort Worth or Arlington, you know, some of the bigger cities. So McKinney is not necessarily the small town that it once was, but downtown McKinney still holds on to a lot of that tradition. And then there's a pretty good community there of locally grown, locally sourced, whether it be those wineries or restaurants. So I think we'll go ahead and risk it and let Mason speak and ask you what are some of your favorites. And let's be honest, really what we want to know is what are some of Jenny's favorites, your wife, who's a much more delightful person. Mason's really great. We just love giving him a hard time on our videos.
That hurts. My wife is actually from McKinney.
That's where we were going with this.
Right. And we went on our second date to Harvest, which is a farm-to-table restaurant. Mm-hmm. Started by Rick of Rick's Chop House.
Of Rick's Chop House, just at the Grand Hotel.
Right. If you're into that kind of thing, we like that restaurant. I've actually been to a concert in the middle of downtown is the Performing Arts Center. Mm-hmm. Really cool old historic building. Just has a lot of community feel to it. People mm-hmm. coming together. In McKinney, it makes the bigger city of McKinney feel small with things like that. There's a place called The Pub, originally named, lots of creativity. But they make their homemade pork rinds there that I am a big fan of.
No, don't do that.
Todd doesn't like it.
I've never had them. I have no issue with The Pub, but pork rinds as a whole is generally a poor choice. But if you disagree or agree, hit it up in the comments. We'll get back at it.
Yeah, I'll agree with you if you agree with me.
Which is very political of you. Some of our favorites are, Rick's is great. Rick's is a kind of a nice night out kind of place. We love Spoons, which is just down the street, actually right, I think next door to Heritage or a couple doors down. But it's great. We've been there for brunch a couple of times and really, really like most of their menu. They've got some really good stuff, and then they have some really great, super unhealthy, but phenomenally delicious stuff. We're a big fan of Emporium Pies. There's an Emporium Pies down there. So you can go get a slice of pie or go ahead and go all the way and get the big bad boy, get the whole thing. And then just to be real clear, kind of the historic downtown nature of McKinney has blended well with some new stuff. There's some cool boutique-y shops that we'll walk around. My wife loves a lot of those. And then there's some newer stuff down there too, though. One of the newer restaurants that we like a lot is I think it's called Square Burger. And it's on the main square, kind of the northwest corner. Great. They've got kind of a local beer selection and then some really, really good burgers as well. So we could keep naming all sorts of great shops and restaurants and pubs and wineries and things like that. But overall, the idea is that downtown McKinney is one of the really, really great reasons to live in McKinney or just to visit if you live nearby. Now, McKinney has become a much bigger city than kind of it once was. That east side of McKinney is kind of the heart of original McKinney. Now, it's grown on the east side. It's definitely grown on the west side to where there are massive communities of master plan neighborhoods and parks and recreational facilities and things like that. But one of the really cool reasons to be there is downtown McKinney. So we've talked about entertainment. We've talked about restaurants and food. We've talked about nightlife. There are some other really cool resources. There's some really cool venues for events in downtown McKinney and just off of downtown McKinney. And, you know, without going name by name and running through them all, we've been to weddings and receptions in the areas, concerts we've heard a lot about. And then there's some really cool small event stuff where we've seen some friends of ours that own companies have had company events down there. So if you're interested in any of those things and you're interested in making a move to the Metroplex or within the Dallas-Fort Worth area, McKinney ought to be on your list. Again, especially if you're interested in items like that. McKinney's, you know, depending on how you look at it, we did another video on commute times, but about an hour north of downtown Dallas. You could certainly make that happen in 40, 45 minutes in a good time, and a little bit longer than an hour and a long time on the high end of that commute, or depending on what time of day you're moving. But McKinney's a great area to consider, and this, downtown McKinney, is one of our favorite reasons for you to consider it. So check that out. Check out some of the other videos we have on the channel around McKinney and surrounding areas. Frisco to the west, you know, you've got Allen and Fairview to the south and east, and then you've got quite a few other opportunities north as well. So check that out. Check out the channel. Subscribe it. Like it. Comment below. If you disagree about pork rinds, let's just be honest, you'll be wrong, but we can have that conversation in the comments. Don't dislike the video. Don't be that guy. But you can comment below and let us know that you enjoy that snack, which is just kind of awkward and not very good. Any other final comments, Mason, in your disgust of pork rinds or anything else?
Will I be fired if I say how much I love pork rinds?
I think you were fired before the video even started, to be honest, but I'm sure you'll be rehired soon and fired again later today. But pork rinds won't be the only reason. Hey, thanks for tuning in. Like it, subscribe, comment below, and we will talk to you on the next one. Take care.
Over and out.